For this task, you'll need the Screencast-o-Matic Pro Recorder installed on your machine. There is a free version, but the Pro Recorder only costs $15 per year, and it gives you some powerful recording and editing options. To download the Pro Recorder, visit the Screencast-o-Matic webpage and click the Go Pro for just $15 a year link. Click either of the upgrade buttons and fill out the subscription form. Head back to the main page and click Start Recording. It'll ask you to download a launcher, which lets you use their web-based recorder, but I prefer to download the full app instead. Click Download the Full App Install to install the app on your machine. When you run the app for the first time, you'll need to select Pro Recorder to access your paid features. Log in with your email address and the password you selected. Now we're ready to make our recording. You'll start by recording your narration. For this, you'll need a good microphone and a quiet room to record in. In Screencast-o-Matic, click on Scripted in the upper right menu to make a new scripted recording. Click on Enter Recording Name towards the top of the screen and give your project a name. Copy the script portion from your completed storyboard. Paste your script into Screencast-o-Matic where it says Enter Text for Script Section by pressing Ctrl-V. It should paste your script in segments that correspond to the rows in your storyboard table. I'll delete this extra blank segment at the bottom. Next, click the down arrow beside microphone to select your recording device. You may want to check that your volume levels are acceptable, not too loud, not too quiet. You can click on Auto Adjust Volume or click Record under Test Playback and speak into your microphone. Then press play to listen to your recording sample. Adjust the volume as needed and click OK to apply your settings. Now select your first text segment and click the red record button. When the section turns green, start talking. When you've finished reading the script for the first section, you can click Next to begin recording the audio for the next section. If you make a mistake while recording a segment, you can click Redo to re-record the audio, or you can click the Pause button to stop recording. A few recording tips. First, keep as close to your original script as possible, or update your script to match your actual recording after you've finished. This will make your life easier when you create captions later. Second, if you want to go back and record over one of your sections, delete the audio from that section first. Even though Screencast-o-Matic gives you the option to replace the audio by recording over it, I've gotten better audio quality when I deleted the audio for that section first before recording it again. To delete the audio for a section, click the down arrow at the far right of the section and select Remove Audio. Then go ahead and hit Record for that section. Once you've recorded the audio for each of your sections, it's time to record your screen. You'll want to begin by closing any applications, windows, or tabs that you won't need during your screencast. Hide the bookmarks bar on your browser. If you're planning to start in a program or a specific website, open it and set it to your desired size. Now select the first segment of your scripted recording and click Record Video 1 through 23 or however many segments you have in your project. You'll see a small recording toolbar appear with a bounding box for the selected recording area. Click the gear icon and change the recording size to full screen. You'll be able to crop this down later. Press the red record button to begin recording. Your script will display in a small box on the screen, and you'll hear the narration you recorded. Perform the screen actions that accompany each segment of the script. While you're recording, you can press Alt-P to pause and unpause the recording at any time. One really nice feature about this Alt-P shortcut is that your mouse position is saved whenever you pause. So if I need to pause recording to think about my next action, and I move my cursor, when I resume my recording again, my cursor will be returned to where it was when I paused. This way, my recording appears uninterrupted, and I don't show my mouse cursor jumping around on the screen. When you finish recording one segment, press Alt-N to begin recording the next segment. When you've finished recording all your segments, or when you press the pause button, you have the option to move back and forth between segments using the left and right arrows on the toolbar. When you're satisfied with your recording, click Done. Okay, we now have a scripted recording in Screencast-o-Matic, and we're ready to move on to the next step. In our next tutorial, I'll show you how to clean up your audio track by exporting it to Audacity.